You know, friends. So I've been watching people play Fallout 4. I play it on my Twitch stream, but I want to start recording for my YouTube channel as well. So hey, thanks so much for joining me and hanging out. I do have mods on this on my Twitch stream. I'm modless. I'm completing the game and everything there is to do in it without cheats or mods. So I can get achievements as well as. I just wanted to see if I could do it all without cheating. And turns out I can, if I have more patience. But yeah, this. I'll show you the mods I put on for this. And then we'll just have a go at recording this for YouTube. I will try to have some more roleplay in it, perhaps. Maybe work on developing in that area. So hey, thanks so much for joining me, hanging out, and seeing me try new things and do new things. Even though I played Fallout 4 before, and this isn't new, just trying new mods and doing new things is kind of new, and trying to be a role player is kind of new as well for me. So let's go. I'll start with the mods. So the mods I have installed. I didn't do too many that will make it harder or that will make me get killed faster. But I have the patch, I have true storms because I like a serious storm to come around every now and then besides a rad storm. Visible companion affinity just because I'm nosy about it. Tales from the Come With, add some more quests and stuff to make it more interesting. The cheat terminal, I'm going to do a few things on that which you'll see in a second. Mostly it's going to be about making it available for me to save anywhere because I'm going to be in survival mode, but I don't like to worry about saving because sometimes the thing glitches out and that just makes me mad and I don't want to get back. And then everybody's best friend, so I'm going to always have dog meat with me. I don't think he should be sitting on the wayside. Why wouldn't he still follow me if I have companions? Favorite water, just because I like to be able to see in the water. Plenty of exploration, and then the cleaning one here, which I will disable when we're starting, or I could disable it right now, but I'm going to have it readily available for me. I'm disabling it now because it sort of gets rid of too much in Sanctuary for me. I just want to get this stuff off the ground. I hate all the trash on the ground. Like, if you rediscover the location and you're like the new person there, you're not gonna just let stuff sit on the ground. If you're from 200 years ago where everything is clean and fresh, you're not gonna just look at stuff on the ground. Yeah, you're busy looking for your kid, but I think you'd clean up a little bit more because it's just part of your DNA, right? As a person before the world ended and everything went to crap. We try to make things pristine, so it'll be slow going. I do like to level up a bit. I'm not going to do cheats in regards to that. I'm not going to do cheats in regards to items. I'm going to give myself a little bit more carry weight. I'm not going to do the... But you'll see when we get there. I like my husband to be a redhead if I'm not playing a man. Even if I'm playing a man, I like him to be a redhead. I don't know why. Have a thing for redheads, I guess.
War never changes.
Good or nothing, dead and the bed is all of my... Yeah, that's how much I play this. And watch people play this.
Get ready and stop fogging the mirror.
I think I'm going to be a girl, because on my Twitch stream, I am actually playing a guy. His name's Rhett. And he looks kind of like this, except he has long hair. But this guy, I'll just leave it like this because I just like the redhead. And then we'll switch to the girl.
My turn, good guy.
I always do kind of like a Willow lookalike, Willow from Buffy, because I like that. I'm finally looking at the character. But they both can't be redheads, huh? I always start with this one as the base. I don't know why, I just do. I kind of like either Agent one or one of the Evening Out or the Elegant one. I think Evening Out this time. Let me see. I'm redhead. He can't be redhead. Maybe I'll go auburn. Yeah, we'll go with that. We'll choose the eyebrow to. Okay. I'm gonna do rested. But I was trying to choose the eyebrows, not the eyes. You know, big eyebrows are in now, so we'll go with that. And then for now, we're just gonna put everything on one because that's the youngest.
Yeah.
Smooth neck. Change a color. You don't want burnt or bronze or copper. I'm thinking we want some kissed. I kind of like tan. Okay. I'm good with this. And then we're gonna go body. Is that all good? I have some muscles. We don't want to be some muscles. But a bit of muscles here. I don't know that I changed it that much, huh? Alright, and then we'll try extras. I never like the blush to the off. Yeah, later junk. I don't like it. I really don't like makeup. Yeah, on my own person. If you want to wear makeup, you're happy with it, feel free. But I'm not a fan. I like middle freckles. And then I like them to be not super. Okay. Apply that one. Get rid of this one. And then accept. Get the color. Not gonna go where it scars. And I get. Let's go with some matte action. We always go for gloss and not super gloss.
Fucking good.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with this. So face extras. Let's buddy them. Yeah, that's me. What am I gonna name her though? My guy character was named Rhett. Here's Cosworth, he's taking a walk. Ah, oh, good morning. Oh,
good morning, Mom. Your clock.
Thanks, Cosworth.
Oh, Mom.
Treat my coffee.
Logging.
Talk about the gardener. Check out what's going on the TV right now. How they watch this TV, I don't know. Not gonna play any music. Yeah, bub.
Hey, hon.
Hey, Nate.
I believe it's almost Halloween.
I'm still thinking about what name I wanna do. Probably Willow. I don't know why I'm pretending like I'm not gonna put Willow. I mean, Tara's my favorite.
I know we were nervous at first, but
I could keep going with Allison, because Allison's my character name on Shift. But I don't want the same character name on both games. I'm thinking Willow. What was I doing with 31st? We feel handy if you want dinner with the mayors. And today's the 23rd. Hand out candy. Oh, you had to mark that on your calendar to hand out candy? Let's see what else we got here. Get more sugar bombs and Nuka-Cola. Bread, cranberry juice, cake, laundry soap, bleach, dish soap. HVAC not right. Again, call repairman. Shookies clams, wicked shipping. That's wicked shiesty. Alright, let's talk to him. Look. Hey, what's up?
Good morning.
Isn't it? You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak to you.
I'm used to skipping dialogue,
it's
sorry.
It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
I'm here now.
So you are. So you are. Now I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time.
Time being a precious commodity.
Precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country.
Is that really why?
Selected for entrance.
I don't think that's really why.
Vault
111. Can't see the back of my shirt, but it says that.
Sounds great.
Let's do it.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of
total atomic annihilation. Alright, let's do it.
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid.
Okay, let's go. Get on with it. Maybe Dalia sounds interesting to me for some reason that has popped into my brain. I'm going with it. So, she's a lawyer. I gave her some muscles, so I'm gonna give it 3. Perception, we need to do that. We need endurance. She works out. And 6 in charisma, just because I said. What's this? I need more intelligence, so give me 1 endurance back. I'm gonna go with that. I mean, she's a lawyer, so she has to be smart. I'll do perception, so just give me 3 intelligence. It's good for now. We'll get another one. Okay, bye.
Thanks again.
Nate and Dalia.
It's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no.
No price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Just a white shirt and beige. Is this what you decided to put on today? Try to dress up for me? Oh, you don't know my name? Rude. I'm gonna get intelligence.
Go ahead, honey.
Yep. This is how you know people are veterans. They just try to skip through this part. I will.
That's my boy. When it says behavior.
How'd you close that door?
Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Let's get sarcastic, you guys.
Because I want to get pregnant.
Uh-oh. I've seen the park. It's small. You had sex there?
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Obviously, the world's ending, Nate. Didn't you hear the guy say the world was going to end?
Followed by flashes.
What's going on, Codsworth? Leave it another name, Dalia. It's a famous name.
We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York, Pennsylvania.
Unbelievable.
My God.
We gotta get out of here. Nate, are you paying attention? You know what's happening?
Now! Codsworth, go! Stay safe, honey.
Bye, sweetheart. Keep up, boy. Like, who cares what's in your bag? I agree with her. The world's ending. Let's get on it. Who knows when the bombs are going to drop? They've already hit New York.
I am bombed. You don't get in. I'm going in. You
can't
stop me.
Okay.
I'm reporting this.
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home.
Someone's going to hear about this.
Who's going to hear about it? They're all going to be dead
in a minute.
Infant, adult male, adult female.
We're not in the program.
Thank you.
Good luck, sir.
Keep up, boy.
What happened to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Now keep moving. Step on the platform in the center.
Hun, why are you walking so slow? I told you to keep up.
Almost there.
Where are you going? You're not trying to walk off, are you? Because it seems like you're trying to walk off.
We're gonna be okay. I love you.
I love you too.
Oh my God!
We're blind now. Can't see. Why are you pointing at it? Are we going? Because I don't feel like we are. Duck.
Oh God.
We under attack. Well, at least we're in. It wasn't right on us that the bombs fell.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please step off the elevator. Proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion. No need to worry, folks.
Okay, you guys, I'm first.
Situated in your new home.
I'm first, so move aside.
A better future underground.
It won't let me run anymore.
Female.
Oh, talk about me. You don't know what gender I am.
You'll need your suit.
Yeah, hand your suit over. Hey, hun, keep up. Bad enough, we didn't make it down the vault fast enough because you were slow. Yeah, everybody's dead. Everyone you know is dead. Maybe they're in their own vault. We don't know. What you looking at on this PC?
Just step in here and put your vault suit.
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there. Hey.
Vault tech is here. Just follow your guide. All set? Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
This doesn't look like a decontamination pod. Know what I mean? And she lets you skip this part too. Time for a whole new world.
Occupant vitals normal.
Nate, take care of Sean, okay? I think now while we wait for scenes to go down. Manual override. Who's manual overriding is suspending our cryogenics? Can't you see? Can't you understand that I want to live 1,000 years from now? Not whenever you've just woken me up. Could be 1,000 years. Excuse me. Can you see me here? Hello? What are you doing? Yo, I know you hear me hitting this. He got him. Yo, what you doing? Oh my gosh. Yeah, come right up close. Let me get a good look at your face. I won't ever forget it. And if I find you, you're dead. Dead, you hear me? There are new rules in the world, and you'll be dead. Literally. But I gotta prepare myself first. I'm a planner. I don't go around unprepared. So you can't get out unless they let you out, even if you wake up. Look at this wet, dirty floor.
Come on,
press the button. Over this door. Head out. Yo, you're frozen. We should definitely be able to save you.
And I'll get you back. Why would Vault-Tec do this?
I think what happened is they woke up, but they couldn't get out. Cryogenic array is offline. Premature termination resulting in system failure. Isolated manual and remote override detected. Control disabled. So somebody disabled the controls from remotely. Killed everybody. Because they woke them up, but didn't let them out. So they ran out of air. They asphyxiated because they were awake, but they couldn't get out. Like, I was hitting the outside of my thing, but I couldn't get out. If somebody didn't open that for me, I'd be as dead as they are. Yo, Nate, I'm gonna find my baby. But we also need to find resources, because I'm going around unprepared, okay?
They're all dead.
Yeah, they are. Alright, check this. Same junk, Cindy. Mrs. Crawford and Cindy. So that's like a mother and daughter. A mother, father, and a daughter. All dead. The Whitefields and Mr. Pritt. DePrito. Blasphemy. Alright, that's where I came from. Once we go this way, but I'm just gonna take this stuff. Cause you never know when you need tools. I mean, I must have been frozen a long time. I can't even breathe good. We did not come this way. Giant roaches, you see him. Look at him. In the power area, fine. The reaction. Okay, stim packs are good. I might need a cigarette later. Hey, Bobby. It's Bobby. Okay, let's see what was going on here. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Security staff responsible for maintaining installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties, insubordination, or interference with the vault operations are capital offenses. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force. So this is the security terminal. They can use lethal force if people aren't following the rules. So if I didn't get in that pod, and I was like, nah, I ain't getting in no pod to explain stuff to me, they would've just killed me. Operations protocol, resident admittance. Upon activation, notice from Vault-Tec, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of Vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the Vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort. Each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents are not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into the preservation chambers, disposal of any detainees while entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. Staff duties. Science staff. Members of the research team must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary and cognitive activities in particular must be recorded hourly. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension and must not interrupt suspension. Independent researchers encouraged and left to overseer discretion. So they wanted us frozen. They didn't want to save anybody unless 80% of everybody else was dead. So yeah, I'm sure like 98% of everybody else was dead, and I'm the only one left. Security patrols are to be carried out on a constant 8-hour rotation. Security priorities include monitoring for signs of intrusion, checking for atmosphere leaks, settling disputes among personnel, enforcement of regulations set forth by the overseer, enforcement of regulations set forth by Vault Tech. Facility service and maintenance. Due to the nature of Vault 111, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. The distribution of these roles will be left to overseer discretion. Alright, then we got logs left. Okay, earliest is up top. October 23rd, that's when the bombs fell. God, finally happened. The world's over. Barely got all the residents inside. Not everyone made it. Now it's just us and the icebergs, and I don't get it. Eggheads tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment for a better future or something. I don't know. It just seems, doesn't seem right that we're smiling at them all the time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them something? So not even the security knows what the point of it, even though they have a briefing that says it is to test the suspended animation of unknown. That's the whole test. They're not supposed to tell us. Let's see how intelligent they were. December 25th, hey, Christmas. Christmas on the ground, got together with the rest of the security boys and support staff and had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy last night cake that wasn't too stale. When the scientists came, overseers wasn't there either, and I just didn't get them. They hadn't sent from us under the company secret order for the higher ups, whatever. Just a few more months, so the all clear is supposed to come through, then we can start rebuilding. Okay, so not only did they not understand the experiment, because he's like, shouldn't we have told them? That's the whole experiment. Then they think their secret's going on, obviously. And then this is telling me that even though these foods that we find out and about are edible, they're going to be stale. Gross. March 14, next year. Only a few weeks left to our mandatory shelter period. In our mandatory shelter period, everyone is getting stir crazy. Some people are even saying all clear. Signal's never coming. We can't stay here much longer, that's for sure. It's not just the fact that I've been staying at the same break room and bunk bed for over 6 months. It's the fact that we only have enough food left for another few months. Tops. The overseer keeps telling everyone to be patient, focus on work. He's definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad is going on, and I just know it. I think he's not telling you that you can't leave after 180 days. It takes years for radiation to dissipate. Like, do you have radiation suits in here? Because I don't see any. So far, April 23rd, the main door exit and the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the overseer evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He has one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from a makeshift checkpoint. Got invited to a meeting tonight. Support staff is security only. Sounds like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. So people are getting stir crazy. They're saying there's malfunctions, but really what they did is lock down this place. Because they knew they can't leave. Just tell people the truth. No all clear for the Vault Tech is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. I almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. And if they're not supposed to leave, why are they out of food? Did they expect them to jump in a pod and get frozen themselves? A handful of us confronted the overseer about opening the vault, and I never knew a man that small could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in the office along with the rest of the side staff. We're supposed to hand over all any food, weapons, and medicine we have by the night, or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everyone. It's time, one way or another, we're getting out of the vault. That sounds like mutiny. And then this lady voice is going on constantly. Alright. We don't know. We know what's in here. Giant cockroaches. We've seen them already. Look at them. Look at them. Look at them. Okay, yes, let's face the other way. And then we're gonna go meow. Death to the heathen. Hey, we hungry. You might as well eat. Yep.
What the hell?
Giant freaking roses. Disgusting. And what have they been eating in here? Each other, I guess. Cause they do that. They're cannibals. Bottles. We got some bottles in here. And a toaster and stuff. It's let's prepare ourselves. We need water. We're gonna need water. We don't know what the water or the situation is gonna be like up top. We don't even know what date it is, so we don't even know how long it's been. And then we're frozen in between being frozen, so what does that mean too? Alright, let's check this room over here. Can I sleep?
Gotta keep moving.
Yeah, you're mad about it. This place has been alluded to high heaven. All the cabinets are empty. Let's check the terminal before we roll out of here. Recreation terminal. Obviously a memo. Remember, the use of the recreation terminal is privileged. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked and drawn responsibly. Top 10 scores, and we're just going to take the tape. It's like Donkey Kong. You know it, I know it. I don't have time to play games right now. We'll take it, we'll check it out later. Probably not, but... probably not. Where are they going? They're gonna get killed too? Where's the other guy? Over there. Where's the other one besides that? You got electrocuted? Yep. Is he following me? Yep. Hit me? He did not. We're just saying how he's bats without Pip-Boy. We're a synth, obviously. Alright, what's going on, Mr. Guy? Who's dead? That's what's going on. Alright, we're not leaving any meats behind. I said we're not. Oh, killed the big one, too. Alright, what's going on up here? Did he hit me? I don't think he did. Adrenaline is increasing your damage. Stay with me and get more kills to increase the bonus. Sleeping will reduce it. Alright, we got the stems. Ooh, that was 50 rounds? Wow. Okay, we got us a 10mm. We got some eyeglasses. Never know what we need eye protection from. Hey, second body. Pre-war money and a pencil. Yeah, I gotcha. What's up, guy?
This is all that's left.
Okay, look in that corner. Look in this corner. That's 10. Another gun. No money and a cigarette. Alright, anything in this box? No. And we gotta cry later. So a freezing gun. Under a master lock. Okay, nothing in the dresser. We got some cigarettes. Preserved. And we got more rounds. I'm always happy for more rounds. Nothing in the mirror. Just take a nice drink. We're always thirsty. We always need water. Don't neglect it. Alright, we've looked around. Let's hit the terminal. Oversee instructions. It's a long-term effects of suspended animation. Unaware human subjects. We got that part. No life-saving measures. Staff is expendable. Insubordination. And attempts to evacuate prematurely are capital violations. Unused cryopods are preferred method for cadaver disposal. What? Cryolator. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable on-demand form. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in a short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Protocol manual. We've read this. Everybody has to do maintenance. President and maintenance. you know, lead somebody in. A clear message. Following a nuclear event, Vault Tech will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasions, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once the condition is deemed safe, the terminal will receive an all clear notice. Upon receiving the all clear notice, Vault Tech personnel may be evacuated. Oversee discretion is to grant any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault Tech, including government and military. And military residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault Tech will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff have been. So they expected them to leave. And this also confirms that Vault Tech isn't part of the government, isn't part of the military. They're their own private scientific corporate thing. Or they're doing weirdo experimentation. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while waiting an all-clear signal. In the absence of the all-clear signal from Vault Tech, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstances may Vault 111 staff evacuate during this shelter period unless receiving all-clear. So, they think you'll be fine. After 180 days, I disagree. Preparation. The final staff orientation is complete. All but a few of the residents of the Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Concord. Vault Tech supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine the wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time. I almost wish I could join them to see the promise of our future realized. I mean, there was an empty pod, so you could have. This happened. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. We less noticed than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. The resident admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. That's me. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people, they must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. So the bombs fell October 23rd, 2077. System malfunction. Strange issue today with Pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic ray almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect the hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override system. We have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye on it. Eye out. I only hope that systems are reliable once we evacuate staff. So, they're already having problems with the remote override. And they misled us, so there is a remote override. The price running low. There's been no all-clear signal from yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 100-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies are never intended to last more than that, and despite my efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. And people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up. They're insane. The radioactive exposure will still be putting enough to fire one, and the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of all-clear was receive additional instructions from the main offices. If you're not supposed to leave, why don't you have more food? They wanted all of you to die, if that's what really happened. Either by going out into the radiation, or by starving to death in here because you knew it wasn't safe to go out yet. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until we all clear. Mutiny. A faction led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I'm not opening the door to be ready to death out there. I'm consulting the remaining supplies within the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. I'm being too damn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's for mouths to feed. And more mouths to get fed. I want to go check out Pod C3. So let me go back the other way here and check it out. Who was in C3? Okay, this room's B, right? It says C, but the terminal says B. So this is C3. C3 is a man. C3's a man, so that does not make sense. And this keeps going up in C, even though the terminal says this is B. Maybe they mean C13. Yep, that's a lady. Probably mistyped him in C-13. But I still don't know who's supposedly in C-3. Who's in C-3? C-3. Mr. Catwoman, I told you. That was a guy. And then who's in C-13? If it's a typo. This is Whitefield. Is in B3. So these numbers are supposed to say B. But they say C. But C13 is. Hey, is this door gonna open now? Is it not? I thought it says I opened the one at the. With the. I figured since I opened the other one, that one might open too, but no. It's locked. Still. Alright. Hello. Not. I'm a terrible shot. But I can let bats help me aim. There's somebody else in here? Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3. There's somebody else in here. Because my hidden is moving. Alright, yes, we reload with R, or whatever button I use for that. Really? You reload with R? It's full. Okay. I always keep a reload on me. They come out of anywhere. What's going on, bro? Need 7 more bullets. Need 2 more bullets. Another vault suit. Anything in this box? No. Anything in this box? No. There's a guy within here already. Got this guy's meat.
Am I the only one left?
You're the only one left. And here's the Pip-Boy, so we're going to end the episode with the Pip-Boy, and showing you the cheat I'm going to use, what I'm going to use from the cheat pod, and then, what else, how I'm going to modify the game with that, so we'll take a look there. Excuse me. Seeing as I'm a lawyer, I probably use computers. Think that's true? I think that's true. So we got status, which goes from, we got the stat tab, still status, special, and perks. I have adrenaline going on right now, because I haven't been hit yet. I have 100 HP and 90 AP when I'm level 1. I got 19 ballistics damage. And then my clothes give me 5 energy resistance and 10 radiation resistance. My special is going on here. I do want to check the chart. Because there's certain perks I want to be able to get right away. I do want to get locksmith, so 4 is there. It's good. I think I only need... Oh, I need 3 endurance. But endurance gives you health, right? Yeah, I'm good. Charisma, we need 6 because we need local leader. I would like to get down to science on intelligence, but the main point here is gun nut, and point. Over here in agility is sneak. I would like to get to action girl. And then I did this for idiot savant, so my intelligence is low because of that. So I like these perks. I could use less on because I don't need kin resistance, but I like the health of it. So what I think I would want to do with my 3 point I'm gonna get once I get out of the vault is go for intelligence to get hacker. Just to work my way down to science. So I want science, I want rad resistance and adamantium skeleton too, so I do want endurance. So inventory, first and foremost, I want to put on a new vault suit, and I want to put on glasses. We're good in this arena. For the true storms configuration, we're going to turn that on. And then constant rad sneak buffs. And why wouldn't we run into a ghoul horde every now and then? And then super save settings. We're gonna make the save mode regular save. And we can sleep on we can save on our own beds because we're not sleeping, we're just saving. Okay, so that'll be my set things there. And then for the cheat terminal, I'm gonna just do some game alterations in that I'm going to do survival manipulations. I want to enable auto saving and enable fast travel. So that should help with saving more. Anytime I go in and out of a map screen, it should save for me as well. So I definitely want that on. Just because the game glitches a lot and I have to leave without a save, and it's not my fault. I didn't die, it just happened. And I want to do companion heal because that is just annoying. When they disappear. As for that, I would like a higher carry weight. And I'm just gonna add 250, not getting anything crazy. She works out. That's pretty much what we're going with here. And I would like 2x jump. 2x jump. Just make it easier to get places. And that'll be it. That's all I'm gonna do cheat wise. I'm gonna have to collect stuff myself and all that and get the perks myself. But yeah, that's gonna be the end of this episode. But I will get this going and get the save where I get to leave. So thanks so much for hanging out and joining me and re-experiencing Fallout 4 with me. I really appreciate it. You know, until next time, you know what I'm gonna say. We're gonna say peace. I'm gonna get to a save point before I turn it off, so I don't want you to miss anything. But probably the next few episodes are gonna be a bit boring. Probably gonna do some leveling up, some clearing out of sanctuary, keeping it safe, not venturing off too far until I'm probably about level 10. That'll include me just building stuff to level up. So hopefully that's not too annoying to you, but that's just what's gonna happen. Yeah. Like I said, thank you. My character here, she likes to be prepared, so she's gonna make a thorough examination of what's going on. Enjoy. So, thank you. Bye.